I think it sometimes confuses people when I just only show them a movie. So, because it's a music performance. So so now I'm trying to focus more on just making films or videos or cartoons that dramatize my songs. Because people are coming to see or hear the music, and I think it helps separate me from the gazillion singer-songwriters, that there's this visual component to the songs. It's still about the songs, but it's just kind of my subversive way of distinguishing myself.
So I've known a lot of famous people in my life, and I called a lot of favors for this next little film that I made. And I'd like to thank everyone for participating. It was very expensive, and I'd like to just give them a credit off the top. It's an old song. Some of the stuff's dated, but anyways. My cousin Morley, he and my dad, they're related on Morley's mother's side. On Morley's father's side, he's related. He's a cousin of David Geffen. I figure that makes me David Geffen's cousin too. I tried to call him, but they said, I tried to call him, but they said, fuck you. But I would not take no for an answer. Don't they know he's my cousin? So I wrote him a letter. Dear Dave, my name's Bob. I'm your cousin. Do you like corn on the cob? Because if you do, you could land your Concorde in my driveway and have dinner with me. I'd like to tell you a thing or three. I'd like to tell you a thing or two. Like one time, Dave, I read an interview with a man who used to work for you named Gary Gersh. He said he was looking for male singer-songwriters. The kind writing about serious shit. Well, I figured that was me, Dave, and so I sent him my tape, but he hated it. You know, I think he played it in his kitchen to get rid of cockroaches. Dave, do you think you could hire him back from Capitol Records just to fire him for me? After all, I'm your family. That's right. I'm your family. Like Sister Sledge, we are family. You caught that. And as a member of your family, Dave, I just gotta tell you something. I feel a little embarrassment. That according to Billboard magazine, November 22nd, 1992, your company has twice been sued over alleged sexual harassment. The article went on to say that woman settled out of court for nearly $500,000. Dave, that's a terrible thing. And besides that, I've even heard Neil Young sometimes sing that his years at Geffen left him trembling. By the way, Dave, if I just made out of one of the little teensy, weensy, teensy, tiny little things, sings I'm your cousin, you should drop Guns N' Roses. I mean, they call black people niggers. They call gay people faggots. And they record songs by Charles Manson. Good one there, Dave. And by the way, I could use a record deal in the States. Signed, your cousin Bob. Thank you. She was born in Elliott Lake, but she was curious. Packed her bags one day took the Greyhound bus as far as it would go in southern Ontario. It's sink or swim, I guess. Toronto was her test. She met Joe Blow selling guitars at Long and McQuaid. He made her smile when he showed her his tattoo. Of a heart grenade. And in the coming weeks, they didn't speak. They knew their part by heart, and they sung it in the dark. One day, black moles accumulated on her 32-year-old skin. The doctor told her she should contact her next of kin. She was in agonizing pain. She couldn't lie on her side. The cancer took her in its arms. Before 33, she died. Now Joe Blow wanders in a fog and sings no songs, thinks evil all city people, and wonders about right and wrong. How come the woman that he loved was taken so young? She was only from a small town where they mine uranium.